This morning, I started a different trip. I was gonna go up Crater Mountain, a little ways west of here, but I got about 3.5 miles up the trail and found a deadfall that was just a bit too sketchy for me to get around. So I bailed out, went to Marble Mount and got a permit to camp up in the Stiletto Cross Country Zone for a couple nights coming up. I think rather than walk a few miles up the road in this warm weather, and I'm already a little bit tired, I'm just gonna go over here and start sticking my thumb out and see if I have any luck. I don't know, did you pick this guy up? Well, I guess they wouldn't. Well, I haven't had much luck with about 50 cars gone by. So I'm just gonna start walking that way a little bit, still stick my thumb out and see what happens. Well, if I end up doing the 5 mile or so road walk, I can think of far worse parts of roads to walk. Okay, this nice lady stopped to give me a ride. All right. Oh, thank you very much. All right, I have arrived at my hitchhiking destination, which is the Hairpin Corner, just below Washington Pass. So as you can see, this is not a real trail here. This is a climber's route, basically. So I expect to have to do a little bit of bushwhacking to get in through here, or at least I did last time, unless I find a better way. I'm following kind of what looks like a path, but I have to be careful. I don't make the same mistake I made last time I came through here and go too far straight ahead, and then have to come back downhill through the bushwhack. Well, I'm having to go through brush again. Yeah, as near as I can tell, there's no way to avoid having to go through brush through part of this. Just making sure I'm going through it in the right direction. Okay, I'm coming up on more open terrain. I think that's where I want to go. I'm seeing a cairn over here and another one over here. That's a good sign. So yeah, when you're following those what look like paths uphill, certain point you need to veer off to the left, otherwise you're just going to end up there and you want to go over here. A very faint trail and a cairn here. Look, I just got to keep going straight that way. Well, I seem to have lost the route again, but I know I'm going in the right direction here. Okay, I haven't seen any cairns in a while, but I'm right next to the main creek and headed up in the right direction. At least from here on, today anyway, I have a bit of a trail to follow. It's about to get really steep. I need to go up like maybe 500 feet more. Not all the way up to the pass, but fairly close. I'm going pretty slow right now, getting tired, and the route gets really steep in here. Fortunately, I don't have a whole lot longer to go. Okay, I made it to this tarn. Going to camp nearby. All right, got the tent set up. Sun's almost down for me. It's about 7:30. It's time to make some dinner and relax. Got some overly friendly mountain goat here. Oh, buddy, stay away. Stay away. Oh, don't make me use my bear spray. I will use it on you. Away. 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 Get. 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 Get out of here. Come on. Come on. Holy cow, that was the most aggressive goat I've ever seen. She was coming right at me. I had to spray her. I feel bad, but oh well, at least it's temporary. That was scary. That was a nanny goat with her kid. And she came up to me with no fear at all and actually charged me. I'm sorry, I wish I didn't have to do that to you. I have never had to use spray on a goat. Most goats don't get that close. I got a little taste of the spray myself. Well, that is exactly why I bring bear spray for wild animals that don't have enough fear of man. And when I do bring it, it's like right in my pocket when I'm in camp, because animals come in your camp so quickly that you don't really have much time to react. Yeah, I'm not sure if she was coming over to me because either that she was being aggressive because she had a kid, or because I just had my food ready. The thing was, is even after I sprayed her, she kind of stood there and at first moved away a little bit, and I had to kind of yell and toss some rocks to get her to skedaddle. I was double checking my map. I'm pretty sure that this spine here above the tarn is the way I need to go tomorrow. Once I get up there a little ways, I'll be above the trees and I should see a pretty clear talus slope over the low part of the ridge up there. Looking at the clouds off to the west, it looks like there might be a little change in the weather tomorrow. If I remember right, the forecast said there was a chance of showers tomorrow morning. I can live with that. Yeah, it's supposed to get back to the sunny weather. I think I'm going to put my pack and my boots inside my tent tonight, because goats like salty, sweaty things. I don't want to wake up to one chewing on my boots at 2 o'clock in the morning. Oh, this could get real interesting tomorrow. I'm going to climb up top of the snow there and kind of start working my way up and right. I think that's the steepest part right there, but we'll see.
Unbelievable. She came back with her kid. Doesn't really want to run away either. Pretty stubborn, still wants to hang out. I had to throw some rocks to get them to move out. Even then, I don't think she's gone too far. Definitely gonna have to keep an eye out while I pack up today. I like mountain goats, but I don't like them that close. Yeah, this one definitely does not have much fear, even after I sprayed her yesterday. At least she's keeping her distance. Well, my arm's getting tired from throwing rocks, so as long as she stays that far away, I think we'll be okay. Man, I don't know what is up with her. She keeps trying to come to my camp, and I'm throwing rocks at her, and she moved back a little bit and then try again. What the heck? Man, I have heard of stubborn goats before, but this one takes the cake. I think now that the sprinkling is slowing down, I'm just gonna go ahead and try to finish packing up my camp, get out of here and leave her be. Hanging out right where I need to go to get out of here. He's a cute little guy, though. Well, it's at moments like this that I wonder if I'm a little crazy, bit off more than I could chew, but I think we got this. I need to head that direction. I don't want to go through the really thick brush. Then again, that talus is hella steep over there, too. I think for now I'm going to go straight up. Doesn't look too thick of brush right through here. I'm hearing voices. I think some people just came up the trail over by my camp. I'm gonna lose sight of the tarn pretty soon. Go in that direction. But now I gotta go up this spine over the top. Freaking awesome. Okay, I'm starting to have some major doubts here. I think that maybe I was supposed to go up over here. I'm not prepared to cross that with the snow there. Well, I'm gonna go up a little higher, see if I can get a better look, but it's a good chance I'm gonna be turning around. Well, now that I've come up here a ways,
I can see two things. One, this is the wrong spine. It should be on the next one over. And two, I am not prepared to go up that steep snow over that notch. So, for my third time this season, I'm gonna turn around. I don't give up too easy, but when it comes to do or die, I don't wanna die. I would climb a little higher up this ridge up there, but this is actually starting to kick in my fear of heights a little bit. Yeah, I don't mind doing moderate mountaineering, but I am not a true climber. I have a lot of respect for how easily you can get hurt out here, which would be especially dangerous for me being solo. And this last part down to the tarn is really steep, a little treacherous. Just gonna kind of zigzag my way down. Coming back through my camp area. No sign of goats for the moment. Yeah, I'm following a trail of sorts through this part. It's still quite steep. I think this is the ridge you actually want to go up if you're going to attempt this, but that looks like crazy, crazy steep too. But anyway, you'd have to be prepared to get over that notch at the top, which I was not. Well, so far I've been able to stay on the easiest route, the trail, so to speak. Pretty sure I did not come this way coming up. However, I don't think there's going to be any way to the road without me having to go through a little bit of brush. Well, no more route through here, but now I know next time I can cut straight up past this boulder with the stripes on it up in there. And that's where the trail starts. Okay, I think I figured out the route through there with minimal bushwhack. It's actually kind of a trail, at least right here. Well, whatever the easy way is through this last part of brush, I ain't on it. Have to be careful here because there's a lot of holes in this brush. Yeah, this is total bushwhack right now, but
going downhill. I know I'm gonna hit the road here eventually. Okay. Getting pretty close to the road now. Hopefully that was the worst of the bushwhack. Yeah, it should be smooth sailing from here. Just hiking down this gully. All right, making it back to the highway. Well, not having much luck catching a ride, but at least I got a nice view. Well, at this point, if I end up walking the road all the way back to the car, I'm probably just gonna go ahead and head home. That'll have been about 20 miles in the past 2 days, some of which were pretty rough and steep. And I don't know that I got another good climb in me tomorrow. A lot of the time I'm not even bothering to stick my thumb out because there's nowhere for the car to pull over. Looks like I'm gonna end up walking the whole way back to Bridge Creek. I'm getting close now. I'm not going to bother sticking my thumb out anymore, it's only a mile. There's Stiletto Peak. I was hoping to be running around up on the ridge up behind there today and tomorrow, but sometimes things just don't work out. I actually have time that I could get on the PCT here and then take the trail that goes up the west side. However, at this point, I don't have the energy. But I had a good hike anyway. Could have done without the goat excitement.